Okay guys, assalamu alaikum, good morning. Today we are going to talk about abstract classes and interfaces. Inshallah, in this part we will talk today only about abstract classes and leave the interfaces for the last lecture, inshallah, next week. Now I will go to next slide. Again, in this lecture today, we are going to talk about abstract classes. In the last lecture, we will talk about interfaces. Now I will clear and go to next page. Abstract classes and interfaces. We will design and use the objective of our lecture for today is to design and use abstract classes, generalize numeric rubber classes, big integer and big decimal using the abstract number, to define interfaces with the class and implementation. For this is for objects, we will inshallah talk remaining objects, define interface, definitional order using the comparable interface and the clonable interface and so on. We will leave these for last lecture, which is in week 16. So today we are going to talk about abstract class, abstract. If you remember in the previous lecture, we talked about abstraction. Abstraction means that I am using the method without knowing how this method is implemented. It doesn't matter how this method is implemented. I am just using it. I call the method, and use it. I don't care about the implementation inside this method. So when we talk about now abstract class, we mean by this that it contains method without implementation. يعني هو this abstract class can contain method without implementation. And also it can contain method with implementation. So the abstract class can contain method without implementation. And the abstract class also can contain method with implementation. So you can find, for example, abstract class 1 class contain you might find a method like this M1, for example M1, and it contains no implementation. Just like this. Maybe it has some parameter here. So you will find a method without implementation. And also in the abstract class, you can find a method with implementation. So this is why we call it abstract class. I have here method and no implementation inside this abstract method. So in this abstract class. So this is the why we call it abstract method, because it does not contain any implementation. And I don't know about the implementation of this method. Okay, I just put it like this inside the abstract class. Inside the abstract class. Inshallah, I will go to next slide to make things easier to you. So abstract method, guys. Abstract method can contain both abstract method and non-abstract method. And a class which is declared with abstract keyword is known as abstract class. We have abstract class, okay, using the abstract keyword, this one. And this abstract class can contain abstract method or non-abstract method. When we say abstraction, that means hiding implementation, as you know. I don't care about the details, and so on. So we are focusing on what the object does instead how it does it. So we are focusing what the object is doing. We don't care, we don't need to know how this method is working. So inside the abstract class, there is two type of method, abstract and non-abstract. Non-abstract is the normal method that you know, that contains implementation and line of code. Abstract method, nobody فيها, ما فيها body. I will go now to next slide. خلينا نشوف هذا. An abstract class must be declared with an abstract keyword. هذا واحد. اثنين, it can have abstract and non-abstract method. So we have talked about this also. Three, it cannot be instantiated. Why? We cannot do instance for this class. We cannot create using the word new with abstract classes, because simply the abstract classes are not completed. Yani because the abstract class, contains method one, maybe abstract one, abstract method one, and method two maybe normal method, like this. And it contains here method one, method two, method three, and maybe we have method three, and this method is abstract, so it has nobody. So because this abstract class can contain a method, and this method actually not completed, so these we cannot make instance of these abstract class. It can have a final method, it can have constructor and static method too. So this it can and might have and might not have. Okay, so and here might have a final method, and it does not have a final method. It can be, but it cannot be instantiated. Why? Because we cannot create instance from this abstract class, and we cannot use the word new with them, with the abstract class itself. Why? Because simply this class is not complete and contains a method without implementation. Okay. Now, why we are doing this? And سؤال, you are now wondering why we are creating abstract class. Why? أنا بعمل abstract class وبروح بضيف and I will sorry I will create an abstract class and I will add inside this abstract class a method abstract method and this method does not contains any implementation. So why I am doing that? Now.
علشان نسوي نموذج للشغل.
Yes, let's say to make خلينا نقول نموذج أو نسميها in other words template. Okay. يعني خلينا نشوف شيء معين. الآن we have this is a common example هو graphics. أي شيء graphics أي رسوم. For sure الرسمة أكيد any graphics in the world contains a draw فيها draw. But I don't know how to draw. بالنسبة لي شيء abstract مش واضح الآن. بروح بعمل في هذا الكلاس اللي اسمه graphics a method called draw. وهي abstract. Okay. Graphics has مثلا get or set color line or set color line. تقدر انت تضيف لأي رسمة graphic إلها خط للرسم إلها لون لهذا الخط. إلها ست مثلاً background color. So these methods are abstract. Okay. Abstract. As you can see here, no implementation inside the graphic class. Now, when I extend هذا الجرافيك عمل له extend من abstract class مثلا بعمل circle extend graphic square ممكن اعمل another class square برضو extend what graphics maybe rectangle extend graphics whatever. Okay. Now these shapes does not contain this method, but ما بتحتوي على هذا المثل. ولكن إذا if you have extend the graphic class من circle قلت له circle extend the graphic and in the graphic class there are abstract method like this you have شوفوا انا بحكي you have or you must implement this method في الكلاس لابد انك تعمل implement لهذه الميثود inside this class لابد you have to implement this method inside this class. So why I am doing this? طيب ليش أنا بعمل كذا؟ To protect my code, to protect my template, to protect my method. بمعنى إنه أنا إذا كأني بقول للمبرمج أو لليوزر للجافا you have a graphic method and the graphic should الكل by default لابد أن يكون فيها مثلا زي ما قلنا set color line فيها لون للخط فيها set background color فيها draw it contains these three methods. Now if I have extended this abstract class in that case I am telling the Java virtual machine or whatever to apply this method you should implement and include this method here لابد انك انت تعمل include لهي الميثود تعملها implementation here. لأنه المنطق بحكي اللوجيك and this is make sense actually why ليش هذا بيعمل لأنه ما في عندي أي سيركل في الدنيا ما فيها ست كلر وما فيها ست باك جراوند كلر أو ما فيها درو again now I have a graphic class and this graphic class contains for sure has أي graphic في الدنيا فيه له draw فيه له line color فيه له background color maybe without color but it is a color بالنهاية now this method for sure المنطق بحكي إنه for sure this method لابد إنها تكون داخل أي shape فعشان أنا أجبر to enforce the user inside the circle اللي هي بالأوريجينال extend هذا extend the graphic to enforce him to extend the circle and implement the method بروح بعرفها في father وبعملها من type abstract ولما أعمل extend لابد أن أعمل implementation لهذا الميثود هنا and the same for the rectangle or square because these methods are shared but actually I don't know how they work يعني طب البعض بيقول لي يا استاذ طب why we did not extend them here in the graphic the graphic something conceptual يعني شيء مش واضح بالنسبه لي it is not clear to me because it is not clear to me I have to put this method and enforce any class extends from graphics to implement this method inside him another example but this example yani it's not accurate 100% and I have a living object living object هذا انسان living انا عندي human وعندي الله يكرمكم animal and so on now here a living object for sure في أكيد أي living object له خصائص اللي هو eat drink مثلا breathe هذا التمبلت العام إلي أو مثل ما قال زميلكم الform التمبلت العام عشان أجبر to enforce إنه الهيومن هذا أو الأنيمال يعمل implementation لهذه هنا لأنه مستحيل يكون هيومن إذا ما بوكل أو بيشرب مثلا أو بتنفس to enforce the user or Java developer to write implementation here AE for eat and drink and breathe I should define them of type abstract 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 لما اعمل extend من human extend human اخليه يعمل extend the living object هذا I should implement how this human should eat how it is eating now I don't ask him what is he doing how the human is eating so I need to implement a method for eating and implement another method for drinking or breathing okay so this is the main purpose هذا هو the main purpose من the abstract class okay so now I will go to the next slide is this clear guys here are some rules do you have any question Is this clear? Yeah, I hope, yani, inshallah. Now I will go to next. I don't see the message. Yes. Thank you, Khalid. Thank you, Mahdi. And so on. Thank you. طيب. الآن we have this method, public class animal, زي ما انتم شايفين. هذا abstract class animal. الانيمال فور شور هو بيعمل ساوند but I don't know what's the sound but here هيو he is doing or he is making a sound okay I don't know how he, how this animal do the sound, because this is a common thing. Which animal? What sound? I don't know. So I have defined it of type abstract class. And I have put here inside the abstract class, abstract class animal, but sorry, created another method of type abstract called sound, void sound. I mean a sound. Now public class dog extends animal. الآن you have to implement the sound. إذا أنت ما عملت implementation هذا راح يعطيك error. يقول لك لا. You have extended abstract method from the animal, so please implement it here. فأنت الآن الله يكرمكم الدق الآن هذا لابد إنه يعمل woof system out print line يطبع كلمة woof. ف this is how what is this is the purpose of the abstraction. Now if you did not implement هذه إذا ما عملت لها implement this will cause a compile error. Compile error. طيب هذه أول ملاحظة. نقطة ثانية, this abstract class can contains abstract or non abstract class. Okay. Now I will share the Java code with you and explain to you and show you the error, inshallah. Here. طبعاً هنا I have called the method in new dog object, animal object, هذا big one, the bigger one. It contains the smaller one in new dog. Then I call the sound method. Now here I have made instantiation of the dog. I can do that. Why? Because the class dog is not abstract. شايفينه هو not abstract. So I can use the word in you with him. And I can do an instance of him here. A new class dog. I can do instantiation from this class because it is not abstract. But I cannot do an instance of animal class. I cannot do or I cannot create, sorry, or make an instance of the animal of the animal class. I will now go to method and share it with you. I will show you the file. We have here هذا الابستراكت. Okay. الآن هذا الانيمال. أول شيء, can I add first rule. Here I have abstract class. Okay. Here I have my, can you see the font or shall I يعني minimize the font for, خلينا نعمل minimization, عملنا كذا maximization for the font. Can I use non-abstract method داخل abstract class? Yes, I can. ما عندنا مشكلة. I can do this. This is the first thing. As you can see here, no errors. We have abstract class, and the abstract class does not contain, also can contain non-abstract method. Now, if there is an abstract method, it should be without implementation, as you can see here. Why I have done this again? To enforce anyone extend this animal, أي واحد بورث من هذا الكلاس to use or implement the method sound. الآن خلينا نروح على الدوغ. هذا الدوغ extends animal. Okay. Now here I have used the method public void sound. لابد إن أعملها implement. Okay. لابد إن أعمل لهذا الميثود implement. لأنه أنا عملت extend من animal. If I have removed this, شايفين الايرور؟ Dog is not abstract and does not override the abstract method sound in animal. So if I have extended abstract class, I should implement the abstract method inside that I have extended or inherited from the father. Okay. Okay, Khaled, I will explain again. شوف خالد أو غير خالد الآن. هاي أنا ما ضفت هذه كلها. Control Z, هذه المثل. This is, yes, I will repeat, inshallah. Now, I have here animal. Animal, which is abstract class, and I have this method. Okay. Now, I went to the dog. A class and extend the abstract. Now, because I have inside this animal class, abstract method, and I have extended the animal class, inherited the animal class inside the dog, I should, I will write here, method should be implemented. لابد انك تعملها implementation. لو انا ما عملت لها implementation كذا, شو أعطاني هنا؟ شايفين الايرور؟ كأنه بقول لك هذا الدق لابد إنك تضيف فيه ميثود اسمها sound, لأنه فيه في لأنك أنت extended this abstract method from where, from the animal. فأنا كذا protect myself, حطيت rules إلي. I put rules for me and enforce the Java developer to do this and this and this. Okay. Now let's say that you have a super class inside your project, and this super class for sure contains a lot of method. For sure, you need to implement this method inside the subclasses. يعني لابد إنه تمسك هذا الميثود تعرفها and use it inside the child or the children. In that case, you have to define it as abstract. If you have defined it as abstract and you have extends this method, in that case, you should implement this method inside the child. Okay, guys. هذه النقطة الأولى أو النقطة الثانية. أول شيء هنا الأنيمال كان contain abstract or not abstract or non-abstract method. It's okay. Okay. هاي يشوفوا هنا أنا شلت من الأنيمال الأبستراكت عادي ما عندي أي مشكلة. ولكن إذا ضفت الأبستراكت وعملت من هذا الكلاس inherit لابد إني أعمل implementing وأطبع هنا كود. Okay. الآن هنا بقول لك في اللون الأصفر هذا لابد إنك تعمل over إذا بتتذكروا هذه over right. Okay, sorry, all small. At over. ليش مو آخر؟ Over sorry right. Okay, over. لابد إنك تعمل over right. Okay, لهذا المثل. فانت هنا you have enforced the Java developer to implement يطبق يعمل implementation لكل المثل الموجوده وين؟ في الانيمالز. طيب هذه النقطه الاولى هاي لابد انه اعمل implement. Can I define another method? Yes, of course you can define any method you want. Public مثلا void sound one and يعني print مثلا وف 1 عادي وف 1 and so on. It's okay, no problem, no problem. You can define any method you want, but if it is abstract method and this method is inherited from the parent, as I said, you have to extend it. Now another thing, as you can see here, I have created an instance of the dog here. I can do that because the dog class is not an abstract class. It is not abstract class. Okay. Can I do create instance from animal? بقول لك wrong. لا, I cannot. لأنه هذا هو عبارة عن abstract class. And the abstract class cannot be, يعني, we cannot create instance from the abstract class. We cannot create any instance from the abstract class. Okay. So I will return it back to dog. Here. Okay. I will talk about this, inshallah, later. خليها هذه, keep it as is now. We will not talk about this. Okay, now I will go back to slides. Here we have abstract class contains abstract method without body. The inherited class includes the body of the method. يعني لابد إنه inherited في body وفي implementation. Abstract method in abstract class. Abstract method cannot be contained in an abstract class. هذه أول rule. ثاني rule, all abstract method must be implemented. هذا تكلمنا كل abstract method لابد أنك تعملها implementation inside the subclass. هذا الهدف من الابستراكشن. اوكي, الاولى انا ابستراكت ميثود كانت بي كونتيند ان نون ابستراكت كلاس. برضو لو انا هذا الميثود رحت عملت هذا الكلاس اللي هو الانيمال نوت ابستراكت كذا, يعني نون ابستراكت كلاس, وعامل فيه ميثود ابستراكت, بقول لك خطا. Animal is not abstract and does not override abstract method sound inside the animal. فإذا أنت عندك method واحدة abstract, okay, لابد إنه يكون لكلاس من نوع what abstract. Other than that, a compile error will occur to you. Again, if the class contains, if you need your class to contain one abstract method, and the method, this method is not clear to me, it is just a common method like sound for animal, I cannot write implementation for sound, for animal sound, I don't know which animal, what to do. So if you have added abstract void inside the class should be also abstract, otherwise compilation error will occur to you. تمام. اوكي, هذه النوت الملاحظة الثانية والأولى. الملاحظة الثالثة, an object from abstract class cannot be created using the new operator. يعني أنت you cannot make an instance as we have mentioned before. You cannot create an instance from the abstract classes. You cannot create method from abstract class. طيب, هنا the same rule, abstract class without abstract method. A class that contains abstract method must be abstract. إذا في method واحدة على الأقل من نوع abstract, if the class contains at least one method of type abstract, the type of this class must be what? Abstract. However, it is possible to define an abstract class that contains no abstract method like this. يعني ممكن أنا أعرف abstract class ولكن ما في abstract method. I can't do that. But why I have done that? Maybe I will add some method later. I might add some method later. Okay. Now, some of the students ask me, every method in the super, we should put in the extend class. Yes. If the type of this method we should not, but we should implement in the extended class, in the child, يعني, in case the method was of type abstract. Yes, Abdullah. Okay, in case the type of the method is abstract. Okay. So, the class contained must be abstract. We have mentioned that. However, it's specific to define abstract class that contains no abstract method. بقدر أعرف abstract class بدون abstract method. لاحظوا ما في عندي الآن. No errors. It's okay. Why I have to, why this is possible in Java? Because you might later add this method. You might later add this method, this abstract method. So, يعني abstract class, it might not يعني contain, it might not contain abstract method. We cannot create an instance of the class using the new operator. This class is used as, هذه الفكرة اللي as a basic class for defining a new subclass. كأنه زي ما ذكرنا هي تمبلت هذه كأنه basic class أو تمبلت أو form زي ما ذكر زميلكم form أو تمبلت أو نموذج لا للنيو subclass كأنه بجبره أنه في subclass هذه to use the method abstract الموجودة في super class هذا يعني أنت مستحيل كأنك بتجبره وتقول له إذا هذا مثلا animal لابد أنه يكون فيه sound في subclass إذا كان هو living object لابد أنك تعمل implement للإيت والدرينك والبريث أوكي فهي صارت basic class كأنك بتعمل rules تحط قواعد لا sub this for this subclass for this subclass Okay. Now I will go to next slide, inshallah. طيب. Now, super of abstract class might be concrete. A subclass can be abstract even if super class is concrete. Concrete method means the method have complete definition. For example, the object class is concrete, but its subclasses such as animal vehicles may be abstract. Okay. So in this, we are يعني, repeating here the same idea. That if you have abstract class inside your super class and you want to include it inside the subclass and you have inherited the super class, you have to يعني complete write complete definition or write implementation tab. The object class is concrete, but its subclasses such as animal vehicle may be abstract. Okay. برضو بقول لك هنا for example the object class زي ما بتعرفوا هو الفادر لكل الانيمالز لكل الاشياء الموجودة للانيمالز للفيكلز etc. هذا الاوبجكت Object class, we have animals, we have vehicles, and so on. Now, if the object class has, maybe the object class has complete definition, concrete, يعني concrete, means have complete definition. هذا الobject هو فيه complete definition, يعني method. ممكن هذه الميثود تحولها لابستراكت كلاس هنا تحولها هنا the abstract. Okay, so now we are talking about the opposite thing here. We have father, and the father contains a method, and this method contains implementation inside the father or the superclass. Now inside the subclass, we can change the method from, or convert the method from a complete definition to what? To abstract method. To abstract method. طيب, متى بيعملوا هذا الكلام? When we are doing this, to define a subclass override a method from its superclass to define it abstract. This is rare but useful when implementation of the method in the superclass become invalid. يعني لو فرضنا I don't want to change the structure of my code. I have superclass. وهذا superclass في method اللي هي M1. وهذا الميثود فيها implementation. عادي. رحت عملت extend لمثلا subclass 1. هذا ورحت حولت هذا الميثود لابستراكت. ابستراكت شو معنى هذا الكلام؟ الان اي واحد راح ياخذ من سب كلاس هذا, يعني نفرض انه هذا سوبر سب كلاس 1 and we have here سب كلاس 2. Subclass 2, يعني we have father, child, and we have a grandfather. Let's suppose that هذا راح يعمل الآن أنت قاعد بتجبر لما أنت تعمل extend لهذا الآن هنا. Okay. Extend لهذا الكلاس هنا قاعد بتعمل وهذا بيعمل this one has abstract class. Abstract class here. ورحت عملت inheritance لهذا الابستراكت method هنا. Okay, extends. الآن أنت لابد هنا تكتب implementation. فلو suppose إنه I have here method 1. وفي method 1 contains implementation. رحت عملت extend لهذا السوبر كلاس هنا. وحولت الميثود لابستراكت. رحت عملت another subclass كنت inherits from subclass 1 اسمه subclass 2. الآن في subclass 2 لأنه I have inherited here abstract class and abstract method, هي حولتها لabstract اسمها called method 1. I have enforced myself, أجبرت حالي إني أكتب code. That means أنا لغيت code مين الأول. I have deleted the code, the implementation of the first method. كأنه قلت له please هذه abstract method تحولت, هذه فيها implementation. This one is converted to abstract method. Now I have made child subclass 2 extend this subclass 1. Now I cannot write subclass, يعني create this class without implementing لهذا الميثود. ففي هذه الحالة when I have implemented this method, I have cancelled the implementation of this method. فهنا بقول لك this is rare but useful when implementation of the method is in the super class becomes invalid. يعني ممكن بعض الميثود شباب بتسمعوا بكلمة deprecated مثلا, أو بعض الميثود بتسمعوا في deprecated, مرقت عليكم كلمة deprecated, this method is deprecated أو cancelled أو deprecated. شو معنى? You have sometimes in the Java or any programming language بعض الميثود بكون معمولها implementation, ولكن for some reason this method will be cancelled, راح تلتغي. deprecated. So they might apply this concept to deprecate this method. عشان يشيلوها بدون ما يغيروا الستركشر بروحوا بيعملوا ميثود ثاني منها abstract من type abstract. فأنت بتجبر أي شخص بيستخدم هذا الكلاس إنه يعمل implemental abstract method اللي هي كانت في الأصل إلها implementation. فأنت في هذه الحالة كأنك لغيت الـ implementation. You have canceled the implementation inside the super class. Inside the super class. Okay, guys. That's good. I will give you a break for let's say 10 minutes, inshallah, and we will continue at 11. Okay, thank you. I don't know about the next lecture. I think some of you might have a final exam in Tuesday. Okay, guys, we will continue, inshallah. Now, the last thing here in this slide that we can, the following statement which creates an array of whose element of animal object is correct. So we cannot make an instance, we cannot make an instance from the abstract class, but we can make an instance of array of this abstract class. Okay. Again, we cannot create an instance using a new animal alone like this. This will cause a compiler. But I can create array of this abstract class. I can deal it was as something like this, a new animal object 10 equal object. So if I have defined array of type, and this array is of type abstract class, okay, I can create an array whose elements are of animal object, as you can see here. You can look at the code. I will share now the screen with you. As you can see here, I can define array of animal, okay, here, which is animal. Animal is abstract class, and also I can deal with it here. Yes, array. I can define array of object, هذا type array, and I can assign this, I can create array like this here inside this object. So can we define it like this? Yes, we can. But abstract class can be used as a data type. Right? Therefore, the following statement, which creates an array whose statement are of animal object type, is correct. Okay. Now I will go to next slide. Okay, Shabab. This is a case study. See the behavior of number class. It accepts all kind of numeric data. Okay, numeric data. So number class خلينا نشوف what we have done here. We have number class. In number class, we have used the number class, أي class, أي number class. لابد أن يكون في كلمة add أو method اسمها. هذه الأد هي abstract. أي number. But I should implement the add inside to accept value of integer or to accept value of decimal. So look at this code for a second. We have a number, a class, and this number class is, we have defined array list, if you remember the array list, the list, عبارة عن a new array list. Okay, then we have added to this list, this value, and this value, and this value, and this value, and this value. Now, public static number get largest number. هذا method توجد. This method will find what? Will find the largest number here. So I have passed this list to here. Then I have write the code here to find the largest number. The largest number here. Okay. الآن as you can see هذا الليست اللي احنا عرفناها هي من type number قدرنا نضيف فيها integer 45 قدرنا نضيف فيها double 3, 3, 4, 5 point something قدرنا نضيف فيها big integer also we have added inside it big decimal BD. Then we have used a method to write to print the largest number. Then after passing the list here, then based on this code, we have checked the size. The cannot fadi, we will return null. Other than that, we have used on the based on this calculated the يعني the largest value. The largest value. For as you can see here, we have a number, class. Okay. وهذا النمبر بنهرت منه مين؟ الدبل والفلوت واللونج والانتجر والشورت والبايت والبيج والى اخره. Now we have here add method. Sorry. Now here we have these value are inherited from this number. Sorry, are extending this number. Now, as you can see here, we have added to the list of type number many value. So what we have done here, we have added many types of numbers inside the list. Then we have bought the list here and found the largest number. Now, as you can see here, the number here accept all types of number of classes. Of it accept all kind of numeric data here. Double, float, long, integer, short, byte, big decimal, and big big integer. So we have this number class. في عنا فيها ال byte value, فيها short value, فيها ال int value, فيها ال long value, فيها ال float value, فيها ال double value. الآن these classes are here also. فيها شيء بيعمل abstract, فيها شيء بيحول ل double value. وفيها شيء بيحول ل float value. فيها شيء بحول شو للونج وانتجر وشورت إلى آخره. أوكي. Now this method اللي بتعمل convert هي في النمبر هي abstract. فأنا عملت abstraction لهذه القيم هنا and enforce all the classes here to use these values. يعني الدبل راح تلقى فيه بحول من دبل لبات او من شورت من دبل لشورت او من دبل لانتجر او من لونج فاليو او لفلوت او دبل فاليو. نفس الشيء لفلوت راح تلقى فيه هذا الفاليو، اللونج راح تلقى فيه هذا الميثود مش الانتجر and so on. So these methods here are of type abstract, are of type abstract because the number and in the number, I don't know what to do because it is a generic thing. Now I have byte value, it is abstract, short value, int value, long value, etc., etc. Now I have defined these method of type abstract, then I have added them here inside these classes and do the implementation for them. Now I cannot create the double class and I cannot leave any of this method. I have to implement this method here. Why I have to do that? Because in Java, it is flexible and allow you to different from all data types. Like تحول or to convert between many data types. So to enforce the Java developer or the ones who يعني created these classes to use this method, I have defined them of type abstract inside the number. Then I have enforced the user to implement this method inside these types of a class, these type of class. Okay, now I will go to next. Now also we have here calendar class. We have also have a calendar class and also have this method here. Sorry guys, I don't know what happened now. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, guys?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Sorry, but I cannot select anything here. Now we have the calendar and we have the Georgian calendar here. We have this example for calendar. Actually, this example is also helpful for you because you are using a lot of methods. As we have said before, Java is very rich and very flexible and contains a lot of rich methods. So we have this calendar, we have get field, set, what extra, get actual maximum, add, get time, etc. Now these methods are in the calendar and I have also Georgian calendar اللي هي فيها برضو هذه the same method راح تلقوها هنا. Construct your journal calendar, construct your journal calendar for specific year, month. Okay, month year. Hey. Construct your journal calendar for specific year, month, date, hour, إلى آخره. Return the value of given calendar field. This one return the value. Of course, this one set the value. This one set the calendar with a specific year. This one get actual, they return the maximum value of specific calendar field could have. And these add or subtract the specific amount of time to a given calendar. شوفوا هنا بنجمع وقت وبنطرح وقت. هنا بنعمل get the time. Return the date object representing this calendar time value. Okay, في مليون second of set. Okay. Set this calendar time with a given date. فلاحظ ان كثير هذه ريتش. الان المثال اللي بنروح عليه احنا all an instance of Java util date represent specific instance in time with millisecond. Java.utility calendar is an abstract base class for extracting detailed information such as year, month, hour, seconds, and so on. Subclasses of calendar can implement specific calendar systems such as Georgian calendar, lunar calendar, and Jewish calendar. Currently, java.utility.georgian calendar for the Georgian calendar is supported in the Java API. الآن هنا what is this all about? Now what is this all about? Guys, now we have discovered when we started implementing calendar, I have added here the calendar class. Okay. Now the calendar after developing and enhancing Java, we found that there are many types of calendar. Many types of calendar. Like, as you can see, Georgian, lunar, Jewish calendar, whatever. Chinese, maybe Japanese, I don't know. There are many kinds of calendar. These calendar, for sure, they should have, they should have a specific function inside what? Calendar. But what now we have done? Calendar now is abstract basic class for extracting detailed information such year, month, date, hour. Every calendar, any calendar in the world, we need to find the year, find the month, find the date, find the hour, find the minutes, find the second, and so on. So what we have done here to make sure that all calendar, all new classes calendar like Georgian, lunar, Jewish calendar, to make sure that these calendar contained the same method in the super class, which actually very important, and you should implement them like breathing and drinking and eating for living object. We have defined an abstract class called calendar. Then we have defined method for year and month and date without implementation. And we have made them of type abstract. Now when I have enhanced my Java and created this new calendar, I have extended this calendar for them. And I have enforced myself to use the get year or get month or get date. So I have enforced this class and this class and this class to use these abstract classes in the super class and implement, inside this calendar. So again, it is just like the number class. We have some method, and we want this method to be implemented inside the super. We have super class number, and we need this method to enforce the other classes like integer, double float, to use this method, to implement this method. So we have defined the number of type abstract. Then we have defined the method also of type abstract. Then we implemented this method inside the float double integer. Again, the same for this calendar. Now, this calendar is abstract class. And we want get month, get year, get date, get hour, get minute, seconds, okay, to be implemented inside this calendar. So what we have done here, we have defined them as abstract and enforced the user to implement this method here and here and here. It is another example, and the purpose also of this example to be aware. يعني إنك تعرف عن هذا الكالندر هي يعني موجودة في الجافا. الآن راح تشوف المثال, راح تشوف الفانكشن اللي فيها. في there are a lot of function. I will go now to next slide. شوفوا هذه الفانكشن year month date hour hour of day. شوفوا لوين minute second day of week day of month يعني day بالأسبوع. شو هو day of month day of year week of month week of year am ولا bm. شوفوا هذه كلها مثل يعني rich very rich okay very rich function. Now that you can use the new Georgian calendar to construct default Georgian calendar with current time and use the new Georgian calendar to construct Georgian calendar with the specific year month date إلى آخر. شوفوا هذه الميثود هي موجودة كاملة يعني حلو إنك تعرف عنها. You might use it in your program خاصة اللي بيستخدموا dates with time in their project. الآن هذا المثال هو عادي مثال بيعمل تست كاليندر وبيعرف نيو جورجيان كاليندر وبيعمل كول نرسل له يوم اوكي نرسل له day of the week نرسل له تاريخ معين وبطبع له قيمة معينة هو بيستدعي هذا المثال. الآن هذا المثال شباب في مشكلة ما رح يشتغل معكم it will not work with you so I have run it here and I will share this file with you inshallah because there is a problem in the file here. خلينا نشوفه هاي المثال شباب there is a problem here it was not يعني it is not working in the activity so I have imported these things and I will share inshallah the file with you. شايفين كيف عملنا كالندر بعديها طبعنا day of أرسلنا له day of name of week calendar dot kit calendar day of week minus one. ليش minus one؟ here we have created هذه list. بتتذكروا هذا اللي كنا نسميه data type. Do you remember this one؟ اللي هي Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday اللي هي الإنام. And we have both Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Then أنا طبعت هنا ديسمبر 1997 وأرسلت له day name of week للكالندر get day of week minus one. طيب شو ليش هذا عملناها؟ أنا طبعت هذه day name week يعني طبعت القيمة اللي هنا ولكن قبل ما أطبع القيمة اللي هنا راح أتكلم عن هذا سهل أنا أتكلم على الآخر هنا we have get calendar day of week. الكالندر لما أنت تجيب day of week تبدأ من 1 إلى 7 ولكن المواقع هنا تبدأ من 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 ليش 10 Sunday Monday Tuesday Wednesday Thursday Friday Saturday 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 yes 7 sorry 7 days so here we have 7 days ولكن هي بتبدأ sorry من صفر أنا كاتب صح start from zero. فعشان أنا أجيب الاسم بدي أجيب الـ day of week. الـ day of week هذا الـ value الميثود هذه هي بتجيب لك الأرقام من 1 إلى 7 فعلشان أعمل align between الـ day of week مع الـ to align day of week with the list here or the enum list this enum list I have subtracted by minus ولاحظ هنا طبعت عملت new date طبعت الـ year طبعت الـ date day of the month is 6 year اللي هي 3 day of year 340 تقريبا صح احنا 340 من 365 week of the month احنا في week 2 I don't know why it is supposed to be week 1 maybe there is something related to localization. خلينا نشوف احنا في week 1 ولا week 2. من 6 12 ايوه اعتبر هذا ويك 2. شوفوا 6 يعني اعتبر هذا ويك 1 لحد 4 ساتردي، بعدين هذا ويك 2 فهو يعمل يعني working correctly ويك 2. ثلاثمية وأربعين يوم week of the month هو week two، week of the year شوفوا هو الweek الخمسين، AM PM هذا zero. okay يعني here I think zero means AM يعني لأنه إحنا في الAM والPM means one I think. okay so here we have printed the year والmonth، عرفنا date طبعنا year المonth date الاور whatever. لو نطلع فوق شوي بورجيكم what we have used in this calendar. شوفوا هاي اليير المانث الجيت مانث بدأ لك من الكالندر مانث. اوكي 1 2 3 4 5 starting from 1 يعني 11 الديت 6 الساعة 11 hour of the 11 minutes 31 لما عملت رن للبرنامج في قبل 5 minutes seconds كانت 12 seconds week etc day of week 2 day of month 6 day of year 30 340 week of month 2. unfortunately in the activity it does not work. شوفوا الان راح تتغير معكم القيم لأن أنتم شايفين الآن، شوفوا المينت والسكند تغيروا، تغيرت معك هذه القيم هي. فالآن إحنا we don't want to take يعني in two subjects together، ولكن الهدف من هذا المثال ومثال النمبر إنه إحنا نعرف إنه في عندنا شيء اسمه abstract وأنا بقدر enforce some method to be created in the sub in the child. okay in the child. When I enforce them to be used in the child, I should implement them. So can I عملت again and again I will say that we have created a base or a form or a template for our child or our subclasses. وهذه بعض الأمثلة. Again هذا المثال I will share it with you الآن إن شاء الله. Maybe I forgot yesterday because it does not work. I have corrected it yesterday. Okay. That's all for today guys. إن شاء الله آخر محاضرة راح نبدأ في الانترفيسز.